Hi, we are introducing today a new C++ 17 Yammer library as part of the release of MRPT 2.1. What are the key features of this library? The first one is that it can parse and emit YAML 1.2, and it can also parse JSON streams. It can store as scalars any kind of data item using the C++ 17 std any type. So you can store in a scalar a string, a double, an integer, but also you can store a robot LiDAR scan, you can store an image. If for some reason you want to do that, it's possible with this library. It, of course, supports range-based for loop, for sequences and for maps. It can parse and emit comments. This is one of the key unique features of this C++ library. And also it can emit clear messages when it finds any error trying to use it. You can use it for storing YAML documents or just use it as a way to pass a large set of parameters to any kind of function you are developing. It's available as part of Debian packages ready to install via APT. And it's fast, as can be shown in the next benchmark. In this benchmark, I compared the new library against YAML CPP, which is one of the most used libraries out there for YAML. And I will show just very briefly that for loading small files or very large files, like these examples here, it takes like an average of 40% less time than YAML CPP. It is also faster for iterating along the whole set of a sequence or a map. And this is, for me, the most important part. It is way, way faster for accessing randomly accessed elements. For example, this in this code examples, you can see here at the right hand, you can access any item using the bracket operators, and it is really, really much faster than YAML CPP. Some resources for getting in contact with this library. First is the documentation website, and also the example codes available in the Git repository. So in the documentation, you could browse directly here, and if you click the name of the class, you can go to the documentation of the main class, which is MRPT, containers, YAML. You can read about the general ideas of the container. And also you have here an example where you can see typical uses like filling in the container from code, loading from file, loading from a text source. You can click here on any part of the example and you will get into the documentation generated from Docx. So I hope you enjoyed this new library.